Jimmy is since I've been in the jungle. I got him about a week ago to get it started up.
Yeah.
It took us over an hour to get ready.
Oh, good.
So,
you don't want to use it for a pint of milk then, do you?
No.
No.
It's tight fit in here, isn't it?
Yeah.
Potential buyers are dreaming their dreams.
We're always useful. You never have too many anvils. When we saw the choppers, which we're really interested in.
Really good condition.
Yeah,
like
fantastic
really
condition.
Good.
I mean, it needs to be all its glory, you know, on the road, chugging along and upsetting all the rest of the traffic.
You've got to have a laugh when you're in life.
It's auction day, and it's clear there are still sheds in Britain with space on their walls.
Third and last time, 21, thank you for your bidding, gentlemen. Lot number 15, the Lambretta Parts and Sales sign. That's a nice little sign. Funny little sign, that one. Where are we going to be then? Whereabouts? Here we go then. Where? £70, £70 I've got.
It seems anything scooter related is fetching good money.
No, I'll give it a minute. You've got to have this, 150. That is then, £160.
this summer. Enter your team online at RedBullSoapboxRace.co.uk.
Dry or chesty cough? Wondering what type of cough you have? Try BronchoStop. BronchoStop is used to relieve dry and chesty coughs. BronchoStop, used to relieve any cough.
Happiness is different things to different people.
It'll struggle to put a clucking end off a nest, I can assure you, won't be bristling with power. But this is what I like. It's a scuttle-mounted fuel tank. It's simple. Got no fuel pump. Can't go wrong. Gravity fed. Unless gravity goes wrong and someone changes it and it goes the other way, you can't go wrong, can you? Honeycomb all lovely, lovely condition. Look at the little lights. Darling little lights. She's a strange little engine. She's got to be over in bed, hasn't she?
Derek, for such a small engine, she's walking about from side to side.
I'll be honest, I can't quite work it out. I'll have to look into this. Because I would expect to have taken that cover off, and underneath there would be a rail clutch. But they're not. There they are. So, side valve, boom, 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 plugs up top. this era, performance cars had speed on this side and a rev car on the other. Because really, the driver, well, the least bit interested in the speed, he couldn't get really fast enough to worry about it anyway, so not a lot of point. And the passenger here has got in his full view on the dashboard the speedo and the manometer and whatever you and it, so he'd probably be sitting there thinking, wow, do you know we're doing 40? And the driver, don't give a monkey's to the ear what he's doing, he does the work. But such a tremendously limited market, really seriously limited now.
Also under the hammer in the next auction, a car that could pull 100 clucking hens off their nests and drag the hen house at great speed around the Nürburgring.
You can't help but like it, can you? It's not made for comfort, is it? It's made for a bit of fun. It's made for Harewood Hill climbing, isn't it? And look at some of the events it's done. We've got ever so many different events that the car's been on. There's stickers all over the windscreen and inside the cars, where it's passed various noise tests and it's done the Nürburgring. There's more stickers all in here. Look, the stickers everywhere where it's done and been, it would appear. Track passes, look. So, it's lived a life. It would be fun car, that. And I think it's a right pretty looking car. Value-wise, tricky one, isn't it? But you know what? If you lined up 15 people there, you'd get 15 different valuations, wouldn't you? You'd get anything from 10 to probably 150,000, wouldn't you? For me, it sort of shouts 20-25,000 quid, I suppose, but I mean, I might be way out. I haven't checked up on prices of C types this week, but you ain't gonna get one for 25 grand, I know that much. So I suppose, yeah, unless you've got 10 times that to start looking for one, then you're gonna have to be happy and part with one of them, aren't you? A recreation of one. But it doesn't shout £50,000 to me. Also, can't be wrong. I'm wrong every day, Chris. We'll wait and see what happens at the start.
So you can see it's a real good, solid, sound motor.
Meanwhile, Derek's taking stock of the C-Type stablemate. Another home-built beauty, the MGB GT. That's been modified with a Ford engine, gearbox, and more.
Look at that. They call it a Le Mans quick filling, pure cap. So, you know, you can imagine the Le Mans car coming out and banging it off and walloping the way. Just a little bit of picking up here. They always pick up here, don't they, these MGs? I mean, this is a new body shell. Some years ago, fair enough. 10 years ago, maybe. But they still pick up here. It's blooming strange, isn't it? There's no real reason why they should, as far as I can see. They do. Fancy wheels. They're quite nice. Wire wheels above all else, but if you're not having wire wheels, then they're at least their fender locks look pretty classy. The way it's seen in there. Why it's plumbed in, it just looks as though it's grand. They're going to be out of the factory now. In fact, if it had come out of the factory, it would have been lovely, wouldn't it? Would have been a big seller then. So I dread to think of the performance, but blooming quick, it'll be much livelier. I ain't got a clue what brake horsepower it's generating, but probably double an MGB by the looks of that. So yeah, we'll go a bit. But the guy buys this in years gone by would have bought and owned and enjoyed an XR2 or an XR3 or something like that. He's now got to the stage where he wants a classic, but he still wants that more punch than the average one. This is going to be a smarty car.